Hey everybody, this is Patrick from Treetop International School and you are listening to the TTIS Podcast. Today, we are joined here by Jacob Gooden, a volunteer from the United States of America. Hi Jacob, it is great to have you here with us.
Thank you, it is good to be here.
Okay, let's begin. So first of all, I would like you to tell us a bit about yourself and why you are here as a volunteer.
Alright, I said my name is Jacob Gooding. I'm a volunteer from United States of America, Tallahassee, which is the capital of Florida. I'm a student at James S. Rickards High School. I'm in the IB program there. I'm a rising senior, so next year I'm going to be a senior in high school, which means after this year I'll go off to university. And I'm here to volunteer in order to get enough hours in to help me get certain scholarships for college so I can afford to go.
Right. Okay, I see. We hope you get the scholarship that you are looking for. How long was your volunteer period in TTIS?
Just shy of 2 weeks.
2 weeks. Okay, that's good to know. And what are some of your duties as a volunteer in the school?
I first took a help with activity week. So when we went to the zoo, I watched over the kids. Same when we went to the river restaurant after that. Helped watch over them and I accompanied some of them who wanted to walk a bit further up the river. And the next day I accompanied them and hung out with them a bit at Energy X Extreme Park, which is this like trampoline park with an obstacle course and some rock climbing stuff in it in one of the malls.
Okay, I see. And what about the physical education program in the school? Are you involved?
Yes, I helped you, Patrick, who you're the coach of that, right?
Yes, that's true.
So I helped the kids. I helped them. I led them through stretches and warm-ups, helped them with dodgeball, soccer, handball, captain ball, very physical activities that you do in physical education. So I helped lead them through it, and I helped like to balance out the teams. I would play for one of the teams sometimes.
That's good. So share about one or two of your most memorable times in TTIS International School.
I think the most memorable time for me was probably the river restaurant. It was just, like I said, it's very different from anything I've ever experienced in the States. And just eating food while the river is just running over you. The river was pretty fast too.
Yeah.
So it's a whole different experience from anything I've ever had in the States or anywhere else for that matter.
Well, that's good to know that you made memories here. What is your opinion or impression of the students in TTIS?
They are very smart, very bright, intelligent young kids. That's the main thing. They're really smart. They all have good futures ahead of them, I think. And very active too. A lot of energy, especially in the little ones.
Yeah.
Energetic.
Well, that's good to know, Mr. Jacob. So I want to know, now that you've been here and you've experienced the education system here in Malaysia, and you are also coming from the States, so you know about the education system. Are there any differences between the Malaysia education system and that of the United States?
Yes, actually. So in the States, the first difference comes right away. You guys start at year one here in Malaysia. In the States, we start in kindergarten, and then we move to first grade, which your guys is year two.
Yes.
So your years are 1 year ahead of our grades.
Okay.
And you guys have college.
Yes.
You go from secondary school to college for 2 years.
Yes.
And then university. In the States, we go from high school, which is equivalent to secondary school, straight to, you guys call it university. We call it college or university. They're interchangeable, which is the 4 years you get your degree after that.
Oh, I see. And in your opinion, what is one thing that you think we can adopt from the educational system in the United States and the United States can adopt from the education system in Malaysia?
I think the United States could adopt the what you guys call college, something like that, that lets kids have a bit of independence but not just throw them in the deep end, so to say. And excuse me, so something that, because in the States you kind of just have to decide what you want to do in your life at 17, 18, which is pretty young, and there's a lot of change in life. So I think it'd be good to give kids a few years to kind of explore, but not fully commit to something they might be interested in.
Okay, I see. And what can the States adopt? What can we adopt from the States?
Ooh, I think, hmm, I think in Malaysia you guys could adopt, said kindergarten would be fun. It's a fun word to say, kindergarten. Okay. Or maybe something similar to AP classes, which in the States, they're advanced placement classes. They give you college credit and they're more advanced. It's basically like you're taking a college class or university class in secondary school.
Oh, that's good to know. What was your first impression of Malaysia?
My first impression. So I came here for the first time in summer of 2019.
Yeah.
When I was, how old? I was 13 or 14 then.
Okay.
So my first impression was, it's big. This is a big city. It's like, because where I live in Tallahassee is about 380,000 people in the metro.
Okay.
And the metro of KL is 7.5 million. So it was really big and really spread out, but it's very diverse as well. Very diverse. The people are very friendly and the food is good.
Okay. The food is always good in Malaysia. So what will you be majoring in the United States when you go to university?
I'm not entirely sure. Right now I want to lean towards meteorology, atmospheric science, so study of weather, how it works, forecasting and all that.
Okay, so what is your proudest accomplishment so far?
Wow, my proudest accomplishment in life. I think this obviously will probably change at some point, but right now, at least the one that comes to memory, that comes to mind relatively recently, was in October of last year. So October 2021, we had our marching band show. We had an MPA, which is Music Performance Assessment, is what that stands for. Basically, where a bunch of bands from the surrounding counties come, they put on their shows, and then you get rated on them from a scale of fair. So it was fair, good, excellent, superior.
Okay.
And we got superior in every category we could. And we had worked really hard for that. We spent months. We practiced 2 hours, 4 hours a day, just getting that our show down. And it finally all came together, and it went much better than I expected, and I was just really proud of not only myself but the band.
Okay, that's really an amazing accomplishment that you have to be proud of. If I may ask, who do you look up the most?
I look up to my mom and dad, my parents. They've always been there when I needed them. They've always pushed me to be the best version of myself, and they've always just been good role models. They're good people. They're very kind and smart and good. Like, my dad was a professional trumpet player at one point, which is the instrument I play trumpet. So he's always helped me whenever I needed help on the trumpet and pushed me to be a better instrumentalist. And my mom has always pushed me to, you know, do my best in school that I can and learn more and really pursue like meteorology, which is an uncommon career choice. She's always encouraged me to do whatever it is I want to do. So I look up to them the most.
That's amazing, Jacob. Do you have a bucket list?
I don't actually have a bucket list. I probably should get on that at some point, because there's a lot of stuff I want to do in life before I die. So I should probably get on making a bucket list.
Yeah, I think you should. It will be a great way to achieve the things that you want to do. What is the biggest cultural difference between Malaysia and the United States of America?
I would have to say the biggest cultural difference is probably religion.
Okay.
Majority Muslim country, Malaysia.
Yes.
Versus the United States, like in Malaysia, you know, the state religion is Islam. Everything is based around that. Whereas in the States, the majority religion is Christianity. Most are Protestant, but we're secular. We don't have a state religion. So there's a lot of things that are influenced by religion here. Like, you'll hear the prayer calls multiple times a day, and you'll see signs that says like halal, if the food is halal or not. And in the States, we don't have all that. So that's probably the biggest cultural difference, is just a majority Muslim and Islamic country versus a secular majority Christian country.
Okay, I understand what you mean. So do you have any advice for students who will be studying abroad in the United States?
Students who will be studying abroad in the United States? I think just a few things. Do your research. If you know, Americans are very unique people, very diverse people. we tend to be pretty talkative. We like to talk to strangers a lot, especially where I come from, the South. Do not base your perception of America off of like 90s movies. People do that a lot when they're coming from abroad because that's their only exposure to America. And it's not like that. It's very different because movies, they're fiction. So don't base off that. And also talk to people, find friends. US is a big place, there's a lot of people there. And if you don't have those friends, people around you can help you, even just navigate, like tell you what restaurants are good or where to avoid, then it will make life a lot easier if you have that.
That is very true. Thank you for the advice, Jacob. So as a volunteer abroad here in mm-hmm. Malaysia, what would be the advice you would give to any individual who wants to volunteer abroad?
I would say my advice I would give to them is two things. Do your research first. Obviously, like I said before, Do your research. It's more to know what you want to do. Plan it out beforehand. Call whatever places you need to before you come over here so that you don't get stuck or you don't get told that we're full or we're not doing that anymore.
Yeah.
Second, be passionate about what you want to do, because if you volunteer just to volunteer, you're not really putting your heart into it. You're just doing it because you need to. You're not doing it for the heart, you know, for the community. Like, I am doing this for hours, but I'm also doing this because it's something I enjoy. I want to help people. I want to help these kids be a part of their educational journey and their development as people.
All right, I see. Thank you for the advice. What is one dream that you have yet to accomplish, you've not accomplished yet?
One dream I have yet to accomplish. I've always wanted to, at some point in my life, get to visit every continent. That's something I want to do. I've been to North America, that's where I was born. I've been to Europe, and I've been to Asia. So I was supposed to go to Australia, but and Africa, maybe. Those both got canceled because of COVID. So I have Australia, Africa, South America, and Antarctica will be difficult.
Why do you think Antarctica will be difficult?
It's expensive. Because, you know, cruises are expensive. And yeah, but there's not a lot to do there, so I'll just be there for like a few hours maybe.
All right, I hope you can achieve that dream.
Thank you.
Who was your favorite teacher and why in Freetop International School?
Who was my favorite teacher and why? I think I'm advising it. Probably you, Patrick. I spent the most time with you, and really we got to know you better and see how you teach and how, you know, you're good with the kids. They seem to really like you, and they always saying hi to you in the halls. And so I think that you're probably my favorite teacher so far, but don't tell Mr. Danny that.
All right, I'll make sure I don't mention, but thank you for your kind ways. Mm-hmm. Well, what is your philosophy in life?
My philosophy in life? I talked about it earlier, but just do what you love. Do what you want to do. Don't let other people tell you what you should do, because it's your life. And, you know, live your life as if you only have one life to live. You know, there's no guarantee about what's after life. People believe what they believe, but we don't know. So I think live your life to the fullest and do what you want to do. Don't let other people force you into a box and spend your life, you know, slogging away whatever you want to do. Follow what you want to do. Get those dreams in, you know, check things off your bucket list.
That's a very good philosophy. Make the most out of your life. What are a few ways that you want to leave with everyone here at TTIS before you leave?
I think that you guys they've been great. They're all wonderful people, all have bright futures ahead of them. I think if you really put your heart and soul and mind to whatever it is you want to do, that you can do it and you can accomplish that. And I don't remember where I heard it or saw it, but I took some words that is four words that I think can go for anyone. It was do good, die great. Do good in your life and you'll die a great person, and people will remember you for the good deeds you did in your life.
Thank you for the amazing words, Jacob. Thank you for being with us here today, Jacob. And everyone, thank you for listening. Find us on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, and Anchor FM. If you would like to join us for a free trial class at TreeTop International School, contact us at treetop@treetophouse.edu.my, or you can also visit us on treetop.edu.my. See you in the next podcast. Thank you.